From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Dave Guthrow.
And I'm Tama Ponton. People will gather in Waterville for a vigil for missing Waterville toddler Ayla Reynolds. News 8's Norm Karkos has more.
This is Norm Karkos in Waterville on Violet Avenue, and behind me, the house where Ayla Reynolds was last seen 6 weeks ago. And today, in downtown Waterville at noon, there will be a bubble and balloon prayer vigil. They'll be tying prayer cards to the balloons, which will be released at 1:45. Organizers say this is a part of an effort to keep the focus on the missing toddler. Of course, her father, Justin DePietro, says the last time he saw his daughter was when he put her to bed on December 16th. He reported her missing the next day. Of course, many agencies have been involved in the search for young Ayla Reynolds, and Waterville Police Chief Joseph Massey now says that he suspects foul play in her disappearance. Of course, the vigil gets underway downtown Waterville, Castonguay Square. That begins at noon. It goes until 2, and they'll release some balloons with prayer cards on them at 1:45. We'll have more details on this on our website, WMTW.com, and of course, News 8 at 6 o'clock. Here in Waterville, I'm Norm Karkos.
All right, thank you, Norm. Portland police detectives and U.S. Marshals have left the scene of a shooting on Mellon Street. Police say the investigation lasted until late last night. The U.S. Marshal Service was involved in the shooting, which happened in the afternoon. Police say one man was injured. He was not a member of law enforcement. Police have not released his name or an update on his condition, but police did say his injuries are not life-threatening.
Meanwhile, York County Sheriff's deputies are investigating the death of a woman in Lebanon after a carbon monoxide leak. The leak happened at 498 Little River Road in Lebanon late yesterday afternoon. The Lebanon Rescue Department say they performed CPR on the woman when they arrived, but she was pronounced dead at the scene. Equipment used to measure carbon monoxide levels reported over 80 parts per million in the residence. Fire officials say there was a generator running in the home at the time of the call.
Well, with the Florida primary coming up on Tuesday, the Republican candidates for president are spending their time campaigning across the Sunshine State. However, Texas Congressman Ron Paul is spending time in Maine. Yesterday, the congressman started his day in Bangor, addressing a large crowd at the Brick Church. Paul ended the night in Lewiston at the Ramada Inn, where a crowd of more than 400 supporters welcomed him. Paul, who is behind in the polls in Florida, focused his sights on Maine because 24 delegates are at stake when the Maine caucus begins next week.
Florida didn't offer us a lot of opportunity because you needed to be a multimillionaire to run a good campaign down there. And it was winner take all, and they cut their votes in half. So the opportunity was here. It was a practical decision, but the practical decision was also based on the fact that we have somebody supporter here.
He's different from the rest. Everyone else seems to say what they want to hear or to talk to the audience, but he's strong. He says what he believes, and then he doesn't worry about applause or anything like that.
Paul will spend the day in Maine at town hall meetings in Gorham, Freeport, and Alfred. Well, thank you for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Tama Ponton.
And I'm Dave Guthrow. Stay with us. We'll bring you the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.